यस आई कंप्लीटेड 11th क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट पार्ट ना।
यस सर।
नाउ 11th क्वेश्चन फोर्थ पार्ट। You can see a piece of equipment will function only when all three parts A, B, C are working. Means if one part fails, whether A or B or C, if one part fails, then equipment will not work. Probability of part A failing during 1 year, 1/6. That of B failing is 1/20, and that of C failing is 1/10. What is the probability that equipment will fail before the end of year? So when it will fail? Which I told. When equipment. Tell Anam.
Sir, if any of the part will fail, then equipment will fail.
It means that if all three parts are working, then it will work. If all three parts are working, then it will work. And if we suppose that all three parts are working, so its probability, what it will be, its probability? All three parts are working. Its probability, how can we find? All three parts are working. How can we find the probability of it? Tell me,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, we can take the probability of failing of part A, then failing of part B. Like this, we can take.
No, no. Listen. I said to you, equipment will work when all three parts are working. Okay. So, what will be the probability that all three parts are working? Because in that case, equipment will work. And if I will subtract this probability from 1, then I will get the required probability that equipment will not work. Is it clear what I am saying?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, first of all, I will have to find that equipment works. Its probability I have to find. So its probability will be part A works multiplied by part B works multiplied by part C works. Okay. So first of all, you write that U1 equals P working of part A. Sorry, failing of part A failing of part A. U1 equals probability of failing of part A. And it is given. How much it is given? Q1 I suppose probability of failing of part A. So how much it is given? अरे बुक है नहीं है तुम्हारे पास?
1/6.
Who told?
Zoya.
Zoya, yes. Only she is having the book. 1/6. It is 1/6. Q2 equals P failing of part B. Failing of part B is 1/20. Q3 equals P failing of part C. 1/10. Clear? Therefore, or then P1 equals probability, working of part A. Or you can write not failing. Not failing you can write. P1 equals probability of not failing. Of part A. It will be 1 - 1. 1 - 1/6. 5/6. P2 equals 1 - 1/13. So it will be 19/20. P3 equals 1 - 1/10. It will be 9/10. Get it? P1 means part A does not fail. P2 means part B does not fail. Probability of not failing of part B. And P3 is probability of not failing of part C. So listen. Probability P of functioning of equipment. P of functioning. Probability of functioning. Functioning the equipment. Equipment spelling EQUIPMENT. So when equipment will function? Tell when equipment will function.
When all three parts are good.
Functioning. So it means that P1 multiplied by P2 multiplied by P3. When all three parts are not failing. So it means that P1 not failing. A part A is not failing. 1/6. Sorry, 5/6. And part B is not failing, 19/20. Part C is not failing, it is 9/10. 5 - 20, 3 + 6, 3 is the 9. This one is 4 - 8, 57. So therefore, P failing the equipment before the end of year. Failing the equipment 1 minus 57 on 80. Result comes 23 upon 80. Right?
Correct.
Next, 13th question. Have you done this? अरे कर लिया या नहीं?
Yes sir.
Yes.
Yes sir.
Next is 13. In 13th question, a bag contains 3 white, 2 black, and 4 red balls. Number of white balls. Three. Number of black balls. Two. Number of red balls. It is given 4.
There are total number of balls. 3 plus 2 plus 4. 9.
Now they are asking, find the probability of drawing a white, a black, and a red ball in succession in that order. Listen carefully. In this question, it is not given you are replacing the ball or not. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So, both the cases we will take in this case. Both the cases. When ball is replaced and when ball is not replaced. Clear? And then we will find the probability. So, if I take when balls are replaced,
comma, required probability. Required probability.
When you are replacing the ball. So, first ball you are taking and that should be white. So, what will be the probability of white ball?
1 upon 3.
1 upon 3. 3 upon 9, yes. 3 upon 9, you can write.
And now this ball you are replacing, after replacement, what will be the probability of black ball?
2 upon 9.
2 upon 9.
And what will be the probability after replacing this ball also? What is the probability of red ball?
4 upon 9.
4 upon 9. So it will be 3 plus 9. It should be 8 upon 243.
Check.
Correct. Correct.
Next,
when balls are not replaced. Balls are not replaced. required capacity. So for first one it will be 3 upon 9 by default. For second, therefore it will be 4 upon
8.
Therefore 2 upon 7.
4 upon 7.
8. 1 upon 3. 1 upon 21. Share.
Correct.
So this exercise is over. Now miscellaneous exercise is coming. Many good problems you are going to get in this exercise. So I start that exercise. ATD. In AT&T exercise,
question number 1,
find the probability of happening of event, probability of happening of event A is A, small a, and that of event B is small b. Given that A and B are independent events, calculate the probability P.
PA equals A, PB equals B, since A and B are independent events. And we are independent events. Therefore, first part.
Happening of both the events.
Happening of both the events, PA intersection B equals PA into PB. AB. You can check.
Correct.
Not happening of both the events.
P A dash intersection B dash equals P A dash multiplied by P B dash. So 1 minus P A multiplied by 1 minus P B.
Correct.
1 minus B.
Next. Third part. Third part. How many are there? Only 10 are there. I'm taking a screenshot. Now 11 are there. For the attendance, they are joining the class. I will not put the attendance. I have seen who joined the class now. Okay.
Now third part.
Event A happens, B does not happen.
Event A happens, B does not happen. P A intersection B dash. P A intersection B dash. P A multiplied by P B dash. PA is A, PB dash or minus B. Check.
Check. Anam is there?
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Why you are not speaking? Event B happens, A does not happen. A dash intersection B. B A dash multiplied by B. B. 1 minus A into B. So B into 1 minus A.
Correct.
Event B does not happen. Event B does not happen to B. B dash. 1 minus B B. Check 1 minus B.
Correct.
Now fourth part. Fourth question. Fourth question. C and D are independent events. P, C given D. P, C given D equals 2 upon 3. P, C intersection D 1 upon 3. C intersection D 1 upon 3. Says C and D are independent events. Therefore, first part, you have to find PC. PC will be PC given D. And it is 2 upon 3. Second part.
Correct.
PD you have to find. PC given D equals PC intersection D upon PD. So PD will be PC intersection D upon PC given D. 1 upon D upon 2 upon D. Cancel 1 upon 2. D cancel. 1 upon 2 is the answer. Check.
Correct.
7th question. What is 7th question? A bag contains 4 white, 7 black, 5 red balls. 3 balls are drawn, one after other, without replacement. Find the probability that balls drawn are white, black and red respectively. In previous exercise, such type of question you have done. There, it was not clear that you are replacing the ball or not, but here it is clear you are not replacing the ball. Without replacement, it is given. So, number of white balls. White balls. How many?
Four.
Number of black balls?
Seven.
Number of red balls?
Five.
5.
Therefore, total number of balls
16.
4 plus 7 plus 5, 16. When balls are not replaced, when balls are not replaced, P1 equals P getting white ball. Getting, you can write probability of being first ball white. Probability of being first ball white or getting white ball. Which language is proper?
Getting white ball.
Or being first ball white. Probability of being first ball white. Because in succession you are taking out. Or getting white ball first.
Sir, getting white ball first is correct, I think so.
Yes.
Getting
yes.
White ball first.
Yes, sir.
Or getting white ball in the first draw or in first attempt.
Like the teeth and knife. Getting first, getting first white ball.
Sir, I think it will be wrong.
It will be wrong. Okay, then getting white ball. In first draw. Getting white ball. In first draw, getting white ball in first draw. Getting white ball in first draw. So it will be 4 upon
16.
1 upon 2. P getting black ball in second row. Getting black ball in second. So in second row you are not. That means that 15. P3 equals P getting red ball in five row. Getting red ball in five row. In third draw, 14 ball and 5 upon 14. There required probability P1 multiplied by B2 multiplied by B3. B1 is 1 upon 2, 7 upon 15, 5 upon 14, 7 to the 5 to the 1 upon 24.
1 upon 24. 1 is not there, I think. Anam, are you able to hear me? Anam, are you able to hear me? Anam, you are listening me? Zoya, you are listening me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next.
Sir, yes, now I am able to hear. Sir, yes.
Okay.
Now I am able to hear. Before I was not able.
Okay, no problem. Question number 10. Yes. Three bags contain 5 white and 8 red, 7 white and 6 red, 6 white and 5 red balls respectively. One ball is drawn from each bag at random. Find the probability that all the 3 balls drawn are of same color. Same color means they may be, all three may be white, all three may be red, all three may be, yes, white and red, two types of balls are there. So all three may be white or all three may be red. So you have to find the probability of all white balls and probability of all red balls, and then you have to add. So here you will apply multiplication and addition theorem together. So you can write,
let P1 equals
1 equals probability.
Sir, I am not able to hear you.
So from my side it is okay. From my side it is okay. Zoya, are you able to hear me?
Sir, yes.
Arushi, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so Anam, you can see your from your side problem will be there. So P1 equals probability of getting red ball from first bag. White ball for today.
A white ball from first pair. Getting a white ball from first pair, and it will be white ball from first pair, it will be
how many white balls are there? 5 out of 30.
5 out of 32. P2, P, that is a white ball here from second bag. From second bag it will be
the 7.
How many? 7? 7 upon 30.
P3, P getting a white ball from third ahead.
Sir, six upon thirteen, eleven.
So Q1 you can take, P getting a red ball from first pair. So how many red ball are there? Eight upon 13. Q2, 6 upon 13. Q3, 5 upon 11. So therefore required probability P1, P2, P3 plus Q1, Q2, Q3. Whether all three are white or all three are red. So it will be 5 upon 13, 7 upon 13, multiplied by 6 upon 11 plus 8 upon 13, 6 upon 13, 8 upon 13, 6 upon 13, 5 upon 11. Plus 18, 59, added to 240. So it will come 450 upon 18, 59. That answer.
Correct.
So like this you can solve. And presentation also I am giving to you. How to present the question. Okay.
Yes, sir.